Hey everyone, welcome back to the Lions from Lambs YouTube channel. I'm Rob Malone. This video lesson will cover two-digit subtraction without regrouping. Now I'll be releasing another video lesson that includes regrouping in subtraction, but this video is going to focus on basic two-digit subtraction. As with the addition lessons, I will demonstrate the strategies that your child is almost certainly learning in school, such as base 10 blocks, expanded form, and the standard algorithm for subtraction. As always, this lesson is simple, as the goal here is to give you a resource to use in order to help your child with both the strategies and the terminology. Let's get started.
So subtraction is a mathematical operation that involves taking away one quantity from another. Subtraction finds the difference. The difference is the numerical gap or distance between two numbers. Or it could also be stated as the results obtained when one quantity is subtracted from another. Now, there's a couple of other vocabulary terms in subtraction that are helpful to know. The minuend is the number from which another number is subtracted, and the subtrahend is the number that is subtracted from another number. So if you're familiar with the standard algorithm for subtraction, where we stack the numbers on top of each other and find the answer in the bottom, the minuend is the top number, the subtrahend is the bottom number, and then the difference is the answer, which goes in the answer spot. Now, this is the minus sign, or it's also known as the subtraction operation symbol, and it tells us that we are going to be subtracting. So we're going to move right to two-digit subtraction, because single-digit subtraction becomes very clear as we work through the two-digit. Because in subtraction, we must remember we are removing values. So in single-digit subtraction, we're simply dealing with the digits 0 through 9, at least at the elementary level. So it's relatively simple once we get two-digit down. So we're going to start with the subtraction problem, 26 minus 15. Now, as we talked about in addition, it's incredibly important that we remember our place values. So the 6-digit and the 5-digit in this problem are both in the ones place. And the 2-digit and the 1-digit are in the tens place. And as we know, their values, what they're actually worth, are based on those places. 6 has a value of 6, 5 has a value of 5, but 2 has a value of 20 because it's in the tens place, and the 1 in 15 has a value of 10, again, because it's in the tens place. So we're going to go ahead and stack our numbers and work the problem vertically, because again, we are moving towards using the standard algorithm. Now I'm going to put the frame up. The frame is not necessary, but it is helpful for children who are just starting with using two-digit numbers for addition or subtraction, and they need a little help keeping their place values aligned. But it's not necessary, and it can be omitted once kids are used to keeping their place values lined up. So we're going to start with base 10 blocks as our first strategy. Now, base 10 blocks are a little bit different than in subtraction than they are in addition, and you'll see why here in just a moment. We're going to represent 26, the top number, the minuend, using base 10 blocks, and that's represented as 6 units in the ones place with a value of 6, and 2 rods in the tens place for a value of 20. Now here's where it differs from addition. We are not going to represent 15 using base 10 blocks because in subtraction we are removing values. And if we represent 15, we will have too high a value in the problem. So how we actually will work it is we're just going to remove 15 there. Now we have 26 total. Okay. So to perform the operation of subtraction, we are going to remove or subtract the value of 15 from the value of 26. And how we do that is we will remove the base 10 blocks that would represent 15. So 15 in base 10 blocks would be represented by 5 units in the ones place and 1 rod in the tens place. So we'll remove those values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units, and now 1 10 rod. So now that we've done that, we'll count what we have left. We have 1 unit in the ones place, which gives us a value of 1, and we have 1 10 rod in the tens place, which gives us a value of 10, but a digit in the answer of 1. So 26 minus 15 equals 11. But now let's look at this same problem, and this time we'll use expanded form. 26 expands to 20 plus 6. 15 expands to 10 plus 5. And when we're subtracting, just like when we're adding, we always start with the ones place value. So 6 minus 5 equals 1. Now we move to the tens. 20 minus 10 equals 10. Now this number is still expanded. So now we just condense it. 10 plus 1 equals 11. Same answer. Now it's crucial that children remember to always start with the ones place and always work with the top number subtracting the bottom number. This becomes very important when we do get to regrouping, and it is perhaps the most difficult thing for kids to learn in subtraction when they're first starting out, is how to handle the problem if the top number is bigger than or has a greater value than the bottom number. But we must still work the problem using the rules we have learned. Minuend on top, subtracting the subtrahend to find the difference. But we will get to that when we work on regrouping. For right now, let's go ahead and get to the standard algorithm for subtraction. This is how we want our kids to solve subtraction problems moving forward. Once they get the concepts down, this is the gold standard in solving subtraction problems. So we'll go ahead and put our frame up to keep track of our place values, keep them lined up. Not necessary if the kids don't need it, but this can be helpful when they're first starting out working with two-digit numbers. So again, we're going to do the top number minus the bottom number. We're going to start in the ones place. 6 minus 5 equals 1. And then we'll move to the tens place. 2 minus 1 equals 1. And we get 26 minus 15 equals 11, just like we did with our other two strategies. This is why the standard algorithm is the way we want kids to learn to solve it, because it's the most efficient. It's the quickest and easiest way to get the right answer. So let's go ahead and start with another problem that we haven't done with any other strategies. Solve it with the standard algorithm. 47 minus 26, 47 the menu end, 26 the subtrahend. Now we're going to try and find the difference by subtracting. We'll start with the ones column. Top number, 7 minus the bottom number, 6. 7 minus 6 equals 1. Now we'll move to the tens place. Top number, 4 with a value of 40 minus the bottom number, 2 with a value of 20. 4 minus 2 equals 2. 47 minus 26 equals 21.
So there you have it, basic subtraction. Now it's a good idea to give the kids plenty of practice with these kinds of problems before attempting to add subtraction problems in which they will need to regroup. Regrouping and subtraction can be a bit of a sticking point for a lot of kids, especially since the usual progression is to learn the addition first, and regrouping in subtraction is quite different as to how it's done in addition. But we'll tackle that in the next video. Thank you for your time. If you found value in the video lesson, click the like button and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more. If you have a comment, question, or suggestion, leave it below. Until next time, take care.